best thing in music might be when something seems completely full of sound and total chaos, and then all of a sudden the meaning or the order of it makes complete sense at a certain moment. It's like, wow, I never thought I would be able to hear that, but there it is.
We'll be right back. Orchestrova is the way the Rova saxophone quartet extends its music and ideas into a larger form. It's not traditional big band music. It's sort of something that tries to be an extension of what big bands have been in the past.
Well, the idea is to take creative concepts that Rova, the saxophone quartet, uses in a lot of our own compositions and expand the ensemble to include between, I'd say, 4 and 14 other musicians, and write music employing concepts of improvisation, the process of improvisation. We have kind of analyzed improvisation over the last 25 years, literally doing free improvisations for 5 or 10 minutes and then stopping and saying, okay, what just happened? And how can we create visual or oral cues like this or this or this or, you know, this, that will cue the other musicians to recreate a situation or a musical sound that we may have created originally as improvisers, but now we want to be able to recreate it on the spot.
With my music, I think basically 60% for rhythm. But I would like players play something that they feel, not just, you know, rhythm stuff. I'm trying to just give the idea. So it's like, you know, salad bowl, you know, putting something together, mixing and making one dish, which is different from just material. Yeah.
Something that I end up doing in my composing for this group a lot is instead of writing for the entire group together in my concept, I will often have 2 or 3 groups that I break the orchestra into. And then I will have the groups doing separate things so that there may be 2 or 3 layers of the music going on at one time. One thing that I find a little tiresome about traditional big band music is how that it's always so focused on one idea. And I wanted something where it could be a little more complex in a way.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
The most interesting thing to me is the level of musicianship in the four places we've done this project outside of our home has been amazingly high.
I'll cue us in, and you should come in a little bit after us.
Okay.
And gotten fairly unusual concepts. They've grasped them very quickly and taken the music from notes on a page to a living thing in the concert very quickly and very easily. It's been great. It's been a great experience.
Basically, we don't create these large ensembles with the idea of, okay, we're going to Finland now, how are we going to work with Finnish musicians and make this work? It's more like we're creating a piece that would work anywhere. And when we get to the local area where we're going, we see what the musicians sound like and how they work, and we try and, you know, come to them as much as they're coming to us.
Se tuli olemaan tosi kiva ja olen tosi otettu, että tämä tämmöinen on järjestetty, että mua on pyydetty siihen ja pyydettiin järjestämään vielä nämä muutkin suomalaiset muusikot siihen, niin se on suuri luottamuksen osoitus ja suuri kunnia, että niin kuin yritän selvitä niin kuin tilanteesta kunnialla ja nauttia myöskin siitä musiikista sitten mahdollisimman paljon siinä sivussa.
We'll be right back.
Thank you.
ihan perinteisessä jatsin improvisaatiossa se kaikista olennaisin osa on se rytmiikka. Ja sitten se sävelkieli, nyt, se sävelkieli on modernissa jatsissa niin kuin bebop-pohjaista, että tämmöisessä avantgardistisessa jazzmusiikissa sitä niin kuin bebop-perinnettä ei niin selkeästi kuule. Että totta kai siellä on vaikutteita siitä niin kuin, ja sitten ihmisten sooloissa, kun ne soittaa solistit sooloja, niin siellä varmasti tulee sen tyyppistä sävelkieltä, koska se on jazzmusiikkia. Niin, mutta että olennaisemmassa osassa on tosiaan niin kuin äänenvärit ja dynamiikka ja dramatiikka.
Instead of using, let's call it, traditional structure, we like to create our own structures because we feel that if you have an original or fresh, let's say rather than original, if you have something semi-new structure that you're working in, it has more of a tendency for the music that people hear to be fresh and original.
I found many people who don't know anything about jazz or anything about improvisation sometimes love this kind of music when they listen to it. So I would like to make them know there are other kinds of music than music on TV.
Mulle musiikissa usein tärkeintä on just nämä live-esiintymiset. Siinä on jotenkin aina mahdollista saada se taika kaikkein voimakkaimmin aikaan. Että tavallaan ne täydelliset hetket on sitten se, mitä varten sitä itse elää. Että sit niinku, se on se, jotenkin se palkinto, sitten, minkä siitä saa. Ja että se on se, mitä aina odottaa ja mihin tulee riippuvaiseksi.
You discover something new that you certainly didn't expect what you were going to discover. And you know, it's, you share this experience both with the people that you're playing the music with and the audience. That's what it is.
It's like, wow, I never thought I would be able to hear that, but there it is.